It's by now well-known Excellency, Lords, Ladies and Gentlemen, in the world of international law that a new judge at the International Court of Justice finds awaiting him or her on the office bookshelf not only the pleadings, judgments, and opinions of the Permanent Court of Justice and of the International Court of Justice, but the four volumes of Shabtai Rosenne's The Law and Practice of the International Court, 1920 to 2005. Of course, there have over the years been